gets its world premiere tomorrow evening.
We've got the talent, we've got the work ethic, boys. If we stick into this soon enough, we're enough to make it out of this shithole.
Well, joining us now is the filmmaker Paul Morris, who wrote, directed and stars in Angry Young Men. Welcome, Paul.
Thanks for having me.
We got a little glimpse of it there.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us all about it.
It's a sort of surreal coming-of-age tale, not so much based on how it was, but how it felt to grow up in a small town like Hamilton, with adulthood on the horizon and the sort of claustrophobic feeling that some people might get.
And it's based in Mockton.
Mockton, that's right. Mockton. The fictional town of Mockton, yes.
And it's a mock town. That's where you got it from.
The Scottish mock town now. A wee secret there.
I was watching some of it last night and I really was laughing at some of the language. Not the naughty stuff, I have to say, but I was laughing. I think you've really hit the nail on the head with all the chat amongst the rival gangs.
Thank you.
You've picked a clip to talk us into.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us a bit more.
So this is basically when the chickens or the baddies come home to roost and the protagonists have to deal with it. So.
Well, let's check it out. Here it goes. We glimpse of it there, didn't we? I've got to ask, what did the locals make of it all? All these people cutting about in their balaclavas.
On the whole, they were pretty good. I mean, the few times we did run into a bit of trouble, the thing you have to do is you need to contact the police every morning, regardless of what you're filming, just so they know and they're aware that you're right in the area. But then sometimes it didn't work, so the police might turn up because they were cutting about in white balaclavas and black SUVs, so you can understand. But in that clip there, it was quite good. The morning of, it was me and Jonathan Feakin up the back of my mum's house, and the boys were all lined up, staring at our back door for the shot. And my next door neighbour, an elderly woman, was opening the blinds, and she got met with 30 boys, built a unit, all staring in. So, good times.
Lesson learned. You did this basically in your own spare time. Mm. And under $5,000, didn't you? Tell us about that.
Yeah, so I mean, $5,000 is pretty much the price of equipment. So I own the equipment, own the drone, everything like that, the cranes, the steadicams, and no one get paid. So I suppose that's what kept the price down, but you pay in time. So it was like 3 years in a day, took to shoot, 2 years to write. I'd get up before work and I'd write it then. So it was a labour of love, definitely.
It's a surreal take, isn't it, on sort of like gangland rivalry.
Yep.
Very Scottish, isn't it?
It is. But I mean, not so much like putting it at the front, I've said that before, not so much tartan and shortbread, but it's just that's the way I speak and I write for our voices. You know, I don't try and make it like overly Scottish to sell, but I'd like to do it in, like you said, you quite like the language, so that's the way we like to speak, so try to write like that.
And how does it feel having made a film? I mean, you've managed to do this in 6 years, haven't you? And you've still got a day job as well.
I do still have a day job, which makes it difficult, but
what must your colleagues be thinking?
I know, I don't know. Well, say hello if you're watching.
It's real.
Yeah, it is real now, and it feels real. Now it's tomorrow, the premiere's tomorrow, but it's a great feeling, but you know, I still feel in it, like doing things like this, but it's having the poster up behind you and being on STV, it's phenomenal, but you just kind of get the head down and take it every day at a time, because if you thought about the task ahead, you would just never start, or you'd give up.
And was inspiration from your own upbringing?
I mean, in a way it was. I suppose the type of emotion, the sort of fear, anxiety, and the, like I say, the feeling of maybe being trapped at times or maybe being a bit bleak. But at the same time, it's more so how it felt, and then my love of cinema, trying to like heighten that and make it a real adventure. That was really what I was aiming for.
Well, Paul, congratulations. Exciting times ahead. Enjoy the premiere tomorrow.
Thank you.
It's going to be great. Thanks very much for coming in.
Thank you.
To speak to us.